Welcome to RA Battery, a demo that is powered by FactoryTalk Innovation Suite. Today, I would like to give you an overview of our state-of-the-art Innovation Suite platform and how it can enable battery customers from an executive to the plant floor level and help optimize manufacturing operations. RA Battery is a fictitious global battery manufacturer created for the purpose of this demo. It has 15 plant facilities located throughout the Americas, Europe, and the Asia Pacific. John Casher is the Vice President Manufacturing and Operations with global responsibility. From this enterprise view, John and his team can monitor the daily production KPIs of their enterprise. You can review the battery production, scrap, true efficiency, OEE, and the first pass yield. As you look out at the enterprise view, you can see that the OEE is falling as well as the production units, a warning sign to review the raw material management as well as the asset utilization. So we would want to investigate what plants are causing this. We can go to the all plant performance to see the status. And here we see that Seoul plant is having a higher amount of scrap rate. From here, we can navigate to the Seoul plant and see what is going on. We can clearly see that Seoul plant is having some issues with the OEE as well as the production units going down. John might want to reach out to MJ Lee, who is the plant manager, to check the OEE related issues. MJ can take charge and jump into the plant overview screen to see what is going on. From here, we see that our plant specific KPIs are up top and area specific KPIs are on the left, giving additional indicators on our process. As we look at our overall plant view, we can see various faults and warnings in the areas. The complete plant is divided into the electrode process area, cell assembly, and the cell activation process. Let's go deep into the cell activation process to see the area in detail. As we look into the cell activation area, there is a red fault icon in the formation line. This indicates about a problem that we should look into. As we dial into the cell activation area, we can see the downtime by duration and the occurrence. And we see that formation line number 2 is leading the chart both in the downtime by duration as well as by occurrence. There are various restart reasons for the line, such as the cell orientation fault or the pin contact fault, and also some scrap reasons such as cell short circuit fault, high discharge rate, or high charging rate. We can go one more level deeper to see that line number 2 is having issues with the cells not being able to charge to the required capacity within the required time. And also there are non-uniform variations in the discharge rates of the cells. Clearly indicates a problem in line number 2 in the formation area. We can go a level deeper in to track the genealogy of the battery cells that are being tracked for their performance state in each of the formation line probe units. We can clearly see that formation line number 2 has higher number of cells showing the status as not okay. We have got a couple of actions to decide based on the cell parameters. We can either raise a maintenance work order for the maintenance folks to debug the issue. Or we can also mark some of the cells as check for the quality team to decide the physical, decide based on the physical status of the cell whether to scrap or whether to rework the cell. This makes it a closed-loop process to track and resolve the issues identified. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Have a good day.